Hey, welcome to another video by Far North Bushcraft and Survival. Glad you could join me. Thanks for coming along. It was a while back I was asked how I get the bark off of a spruce tree if I'm going to use it for survival food or whatever. So that's what this video is going to be about. Let me get the camera set up and I'll come back. Okay, here is a down spruce tree. It was knocked down by other trees falling down on it and knocked it down. I've been peeling away a little bit of bark here. I'll show you how I do it. Okay, this is in the springtime. You probably saw the snow in the background a little bit earlier. So this bark is going to come off real easy. I got to keep my hatchet pretty sharp. And just skin off this outer bark. However far I want to go. Okay. Well, we'll take off one more strip here. Okay, now you can use your knife or I'm gonna use my hatchet. You just go in a little bit deeper. Okay, you want to make sure you don't go into the wood. Just this inner layer and this inner cambium layer. Now, this is very, right now, especially in the spring, it's very rich in sap. And besides eating this, you could boil this up and it would make it a little more palatable. It's quite strong tasting, eat it as it is, but you can. But another use, for this, since it is so full of sap, is, okay, say you're out and you've got a cut, quite a bad cut, but you could use this as a bandage. It works quite well. It would keep your cut clean. There. Now, if you want it on here a little bit better, maybe find you a willow branch and cut that willow branch, cut the bark off of that, use the cambium bark of the willow branch. And tie over this, it'll hold it on real good. Now something else you could do is look around, find a spruce tree that's got some sap on it that's still runny, and you could there's not any here available, I don't think. Maybe there is. I see some right up here, maybe. Let's take a look here. Yes, this will work. Hopefully I'm in the video. Okay, this is still sticky liquid sap. This is excellent. Okay. Okay, on your injury, smear this sap into it, and then put your bandage on. Yeah, it's going to be kind of dirty and whatnot. Sticky and not that pretty looking. But you really don't care about pretty. Leastways I don't. What you care about is germs. I've got a friend that he was the Tlingit Indian friend from Southeast Alaska. He was cutting on some boards, cutting on some wood, and let me kind of demonstrate, even though I don't have my saw out. Okay, he was sawing with his saw, and the blade jumped and hit his thumb, cut through his thumb real deep. One of his other Indian friends took some pitch, like I just showed you, put pitch on that, and they were out remote. They had been flown in, landed. They couldn't get themselves out. They had to have a plane come in. It'd be a while before the plane could get there. Well, that's how they kept the wound clean and kept it from getting infected. Well, that's just a few tips about spruce. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.